Right, we have discussed last time regarding acne, right? So today we are starting another topic that is on vitiligo. That is again a common skin condition, right? So the objectives of the lecture are that you should be able to understand the factors which governs the skin color. What is the etiology of deep pigmentary disorders and how you will define vitiligo specifically? You should understand the pathophysiology of vitiligo, the clinical features of vitiligo, know the differential diagnosis of vitiligo, and you should be able to know the treatment part of vitiligo too. Skin color is usually governed by mainly melanin, which is present in the epidermis. Apart from melanin, the somewhat contribution will be because of the keratinites in the epidermis and blood in the dermis, which is either oxygenated or deoxygenated. Because of the oxygenated hemoglobin or deoxygenated hemoglobin, it will also contribute somewhat to the color of the skin. But the main component contribution for skin color is melanin, which is produced in the melanocytes. Right? And these melanocytes are the specialized structures or specialized cells present in the basal cell layer of the epidermis. As you know, it is a dendritic cell, right? And there are melanosomes in the cytoplasm of the melanocytes where the melanin is produced. Right, and this melanin is transferred to the surrounding keratinocytes, right, with the help of dendrites. Right, so one melanocyte will transfer to around 36 keratinocytes. The melanin from one melanocyte is usually transferred to around 36 surrounding keratinocytes, right? The ratio of the melanocytes to the basal cells in the basal cell layer is usually 9:1, means 9 basal cells and then 1 melanocytes. This melanocyte is not forming any desmosomes with the adjacent basal cell. Okay, otherwise the two adjacent basal cells will have desmosomes at the adjacent cell wall. But the melanocyte cell wall will not form desmosomes with the adjacent basal cell. Right? So as you know, the tyrosine is the main amino acid from which the melanin is produced, and the tyrosine is the rate limiting enzyme. So there may be two types of melanin which can be produced. One is eumelanin and second one is the pheomelanin. Right? The color of the skin is dependent on the, not on the number of melanocytes in the per millimeter square of the skin, because it is usually almost same in all races. Either it is black race or white, the per millimeter square number of melanocytes in the skin is almost same. But it is the rate of transfer of melanin or melanocytes, melanosomes to the surrounding keratinocytes, number one. Number two, size of the melanosomes, size of the melanosomes. And number three, type of the melanin which will govern the of skin, right? Rate of transfer of melanin or melanosomes to the surrounding keratinocytes. Number two, size of the melanosomes. And number three, the type of the melanin which is produced will govern the color, not the number of melanocytes. Right? So today we are only discussing the deep pigmented disorder, that is vitiligo. So if we try to classify depigmentation, we can classify into two broad groups. One is because of the loss of melanocytes. Loss of melanocytes, that is known as melanocytopenic. Melanocytopenic means factory is destroyed. Melanocyte is a factory for the production of melanin, right? And this loss of melanocytes can be either acquired or it can be congenital also. Uncommonly, it can be congenital, but commonly it is the acquired type of loss of melanocyte which leads to usually depigmentation. And the causes of acquired loss of melanocytes, the most common cause is vitiligo, right? Second one is chemical leukoderma, burn injury, trauma, vitamin B12 deficiency, and post-inflammatory hypo or depigmentation. And the important cause of congenital loss of melanocyte is pybaldism. Pybaldism. Actually, the melanocytes or melanoblasts, they are transferred during the embryonal life from the कहाँ से ट्रांसफर होते हैं इसमें फ्रॉम द न्यूरल क्रेस्ट राइट द मेलानोब्लास्ट आर ट्रांसफर्ड फ्रॉम द न्यूरल क्रेस्ट ड्यूरिंग द एम्ब्रियोनल लाइफ टुवर्ड्स द बेसल सेल लेयर ऑफ द स्किन एंड दिस ट्रांसफर ऑफ द मेलानोब्लास्ट मेलानोसाइट्स इन द फ्यूटर लाइफ is governed by a gene known as c-kit gene, c-kit gene, which governs the transfer of melanoblast from the neural crest. So there is a mutation in that c-kit gene which will hamper or disorganize the transfer of melanoblast from the neural crest, and there will be loss of melanocytes from birth at some places in the skin. That is, the disease will develop, that is pybaldism, right? And there are some other syndromes which are uncommon, but you should know at least two causes. One is vitiligo, which is the acquired cause of loss of melanocytes, and one is pybaldism, that is congenital loss of melanocytes leading to depigmentation. Means the child will have birth with depigmentary macules, right? But in vitiligo, the patient will develop depigmentation later on in the life. Okay? The second broad group will be dysfunction of the melanocytes, right? तो एक तो फैक्ट्री खराब मतलब डिस्ट्रॉय हो गई. सेकेंड, देर इज ए प्रॉब्लम इन द प्रोडक्शन, दैट इज डिसफंक्शन ऑफ द मेलानोसाइट्स मींस प्रॉब्लम इन द मेलानिन पिगमेंटेशन पिगमेंट प्रोडक्शन, दैट इज नोन एज मेलानोपेनिक. मेलानोपेनिक एंड द मेन कॉज ऑफ दिस मेलानोपेनिक कॉज इज एल्बिनिज्म. That is because of the mutation in the tyrosinase enzyme leading to the problem in the melanin production, right? That is congenital usually, and There are different types of learning that we are not going to discuss, but you should know these three terms: vitiligo, pyoidism, and albinism, which are the main causes for the depigmentation. Two for loss of melanocytes, and one is for dysfunction of melanocytes. Okay, there are some other causes like vitreous versicular. You must have seen some cases of vitreous versicular in the clinics, where you must have seen hypopigmentary lesions, macules, right, on the trunk. Okay, that we will be going to discuss the DD also. Then pityriasis alba, PKDL, endocrine disorders, right, tuberous sclerosis. कोई केस देखा है tuberous sclerosis का पीडिया में? No, have you seen any case of tuberous sclerosis? No? Okay. So we will discuss in detail vitiligo. So vitiligo is an acquired progressive disorder that selectively destroys some or all melanocytes residing in the interfollicular epidermis and sometimes in the hair follicle as well. It is an acquired progressive disorder which leads to destruction of some or all melanocytes in the interfollicular epidermis and sometimes in the hair follicle as well. Okay. Clinically characterized by milky or chalky white macules. Right? Milky or chalky white macules. And the course of the disease is not defined. It is unpredictable. Okay? कहने का मतलब है या तो केवल मेलानोसाइट विच आर रिजाइडिंग इन द बेसल सेल लेयर वो डिस्ट्रॉय हो जाएं, या फिर साथ में जो हेयर फॉलिकल में मेलानोसाइट्स होती हैं वो भी डिस्ट्रॉय हो जाएं. कहां कहां पे होती मेलानोसाइट्स अपार्ट फ्रॉम स्किन? व्हाट आर द अदर साइट्स वेयर यू कैन फाइंड मेलानोसाइट्स अपार्ट फ्रॉम स्किन? Any one or two example or sites? Very common है. एक तो आई भी नहीं होता काला काला, हाँ? आई में और कहाँ होता है इसके अलावा? Right. So to understand the pathogenesis is important to understand the how to treat, है ना? पहले pathogenesis important है. So there are three hypotheses regarding the pathogenesis of vitiligo, and the most important accepted one is immune hypothesis, that there are antibodies against the surface antigens on the melanocytes. Antibodies against the surface antigens on the melanocytes which will destroy the melanocytes, right? And this hypothesis is supported by the fact that the level of antibodies will reflect in the extension of the vitiligo macules or area, right? The extent of depigmentation and activity of the vitiligo will depend on the antibody titer, right? Also, the vitiligo antibodies can kill the melanocytes in vitro and in vivo, and this is also supported by the fact that vitiligo is also associated with some other autoimmune diseases, like it can be alopecia areata, it can be pernicious anemia or thyroid disorders or many others, right? Chicken. The second hypothesis is autocytotoxic theory. Autocytotoxic theory. Some of the byproducts ड्यूरिंग द मिलेनिन प्रोडक्शन आर मिलेनोसाइटोटॉक्सिक. सम ऑफ द बाय प्रोडक्ट्स ड्यूरिंग द मिलेनिन प्रोडक्शन आर मिलेनोसाइटोटॉक्सिक मीन्स दे कैन किल द मिलेनोसाइट्स, बट इन ए नॉर्मल इंडिविजुअल देर इज ए प्रोटेक्टिव मैकेनिज्म विच विल इलिमिनेट दैट दीज बाय प्रोडक्ट्स. राइट, इन नॉर्मल इंडिविजुअल दीज बाय प्रोडक्ट्स विल बी एलिमिनेटेड, बट इन पेशेंट्स विद विटिलाइगो दिस प्रोटेक्टिव मैकेनिज्म इज नॉट देयर एंड द बाय प्रोडक्ट्स ड्यूरिंग द मेलानिन सिंथेसिस मे किल द मेलानोसाइट्स. राइट, and the third theory is the neural hypothesis, which says that there is a secretion of neuropeptide Y, and this neuropeptide Y from the nerve endings is melanocytotoxic, destroying the melanocytes. But this type of vitiligo will not be able to explain all types of vitiligo. It can well explain the segmental type of vitiligo. Right? Okay. So the most accepted one is the immune hypothesis. Means it is a autoimmune disease. It is a production of antibodies that will destroy the melanocytes. The prevalence of vitiligo in India is around 0.5 to 1.5 or 1.8. Both sexes are affected equally. Age of onset can be just after birth and till late age, that is in 8th, till 81 age, years reported. Till 81 years, right? So it can develop at any age, but the mean age of onset is around second and third decade. Mean age of onset is around third and second decade, right? It is a multifactorial disease and it has got some polygenic inheritance. Right, 20% of the patients of vitiligo will give history of family involvement in the first degree generation, and there will be 7-fold increase of the relative risk in the first generation. Right, the RR will increase to 7 to 10 folds in the first generation. There is positive association with HLA-DR4 and negative association with DR3. Right? It is not required for you. Clinically, you must have seen some patients in clinics also, vitiligo. Kisne dekha hai? Posting chal rahi hai tum log ki? J batch? Haan bhai. Have you seen a case of vitiligo in clinic? No. So classically it will present as chalky white or milky white depigmented macule or white macule with sharp or well defined convex margins. ठीक है, चल नहीं आज, चल तो रहा है. तो यू कैन सी दैट दिस कॉन्वेक्सिटी, ठीक है, यूजुअली द न्यू लीजन और जो प्रोग्रेसिव लीजन होगा दैट विल हैव ए कॉन्वेक्स मार्जिन. राइट, द नंबर में वेरी, मे बी फ्यू इन नंबर और सेवरल इन नंबर, एंड ऑल्सो द साइज में वेरी, एंड समटाइम्स इट मे बी एसोसिएटेड विद leukotrichia, that is depigmentation in the hair follicle, right? So if you see depigmentary changes in the hair in the within the macule, then it is known as leukotrichia, right? Okay. Not in all patients. Some patients will have leukotrichosis. So if we try to classify vitiligo, we can classify it into this type of vitiligo usually seen in adolescent age group, children and adolescent age group. Yeah, is usually not seen. Or you can say leukotrichia is usually seen at the periphery of the leukemia. Times classically at the periphery of the lesion or just beyond the lesion, you can see the leukotrichia. Kobner phenomenon is not there in segmental vitiligo. Not associated with any genetics. Family history is not usually positive in segmental vitiligo. Right? The problem with segmental vitiligo is that it is a poor responder to the medical therapies. It is a poor responder to medical therapies. Okay? These are the other examples of segmental vitiligo, right? Then the generalized type, first generalized type is acrofacial vitiligo. Acrofacial means involvement of distal part of these are the periocular lesions. Then the second type is vitiligo vulgaris, where you can see the widespread depigmented macules which are symmetrically distributed and involving the almost all parts of the body. ठीक है तो मिक्स विटिलिगो को बताई थी हमने थर्ड टाइप जो थर्ड कैटेगरी है सेगमेंटल विटिलिगो को क्या है डिफरेंशियल डायग्नोसिस ऑफ विटिलिगो. One is nevus hypochromicus. Nevus hypochromicus. You can see a deep pigmented macule, right? But the border you can see is macular. This type of macules will be present at birth. Nevus. जो होंगे या तो विद इन वन मंथ दिख जाएंगे या फिर एट बर्थ होंगे. ठीक है एंड दे विल इंक्रीज विद द बॉडी चेंज इन द बॉडी साइज इन द सेम प्रोपोर्शन. ठीक है नेवस डीपिगमेंटोसिस और हाइपोक्रोमिकस. देन लेप्रोसिस समटाइम्स कैन बी कंफ्यूज. The surface changes and the other neural examination to categorize it as leprosy. Then chemical leukoderma almost look like vitiligo. Okay, you can see the bindi area where there is a blue. Then PKDL, post Kalajar dermal leishmaniasis. You can see the hyperpigmentation of the almost like vitiligo. Okay, but there will be some other features like succulent erythematous, juicy looking papules and plaques on the central part of the face, right, or on the genitalia and the history. Then pityriasis versicolor. Ye to dekha tumne. Hyperpigmented. scales over the surface. And they are usually confined to the upper trunk. Vitreous is alba. And there is entity known as idiopathic guttate hypomelanosis. Idiopathic guttate hypomelanosis, where you can see tiny depigmented macules, and these macules are shiny, having irregular border. Yeah. These are usually seen in elderly patients. These are the DDs, right? The other DDs can be ash leaf macules in the tuberous sclerosis. Will be deep pigmented open body. Then course of the vitiligo, that we have told that it is usually unpredictable. There is no defined course. The natural course is of slow progression. The spread of the lesions can be either by the appearance of new lesions or by the extension of the existing depigmented macules. Spontaneous repigmentation may occur, but usually it is minimal. Factors which affect the progression of vitiligo are the clinical type. Of just segmental vitiligo hai, full blown, so it will not spread. Family history usually is there for no role. But cognates from now, yes. Yes. Is always related to progression. Then coming to treatment part, which is the main topic of the lecture as per the competency. So the aim of the treatment is, one is to arrest the progression of vitiligo. It is giving history that the new lesions are either appearing. Second aim is will be the repigmentation. Right. So for arresting the progression, usually the steroid are the main history of treatment, as it is an autoimmune disease. So corticosteroids can be given either in the daily form, daily doses, or in the form of oral mini pulse. Oral mini pulse. This oral mini pulse is designed to reduce down the side effects of the daily corticosteroid. Oral mini pulse, the third type of pulse is known as high dose monthly pulse. Pulse therapy. Here, then apart from corticosteroids, you can add immunomodulators like levamisole is an immunomodulator, which can be given along with the corticosteroids, but there are not much studies. It's a dose of 150 milligram for 3 or 2 days in a week. Then you can add immunosuppressant. Suppressants like azathioprine, cyclophosphamide, methotrexate. For repigmentation, the factors which affect the pigmentation or type of vitiligo. Then sites of involvement, the sites which are divided up here are help. Leukotrichia, agar saath mein associated hai, then there will be less chances of repigmentation. Progressive or non-progressive, agar vitiligo progressive hai, then there are fair chances of age of the patient, yes. The drugs which can be used again are topical corticosteroids for repigmentation, which can be of moderate potencies like betamethasone, fluticasone, fluconazole, right? These can be, or mometasone. These type of moderate potency corticosteroids should be used, and high potency corticosteroids should be reserved only for the thick skin like palm and sole. Right? The topical steroid patient which can be very well managed with the topical steroid. What are these? Then the other mode of therapy is photochemotherapy. Oral and topical. There is another form of photochemotherapy that is known as topical photochemotherapy. Right. Then, apart from this photochemotherapy, the other drugs which are now available are tacrolimus. Sorry. Then the other uncommon is phenylalanine. Phenylalanine. Right? Now also JAK inhibitors, that is various kinase inhibitors. But in phototherapy, only the exposure is done. Exposure. You can give. Okay. Then coming to the surgical therapies. Then the other surgical therapies are split thickness grafting, make non-cultured epidermis and melanocyte suspension. But these are the common modalities for the treatment. So you should be knowing at least the medical part and the photo and photochemotherapy that will be used for the treatment. So this is now finished, I think. Okay.